Indiana Jones is the coolest archaeologist ever. But on today's bogus movie science, we're gonna find out if even Dr. Jones could survive nuking the fridge.
In Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, Harrison Ford's titular character unwittingly stumbles into a nuclear test site. Walking through a prefab house hosting a family of mannequins, Indy takes refuge inside a refrigerator. The atomic blast catapults the fridge through the toxic air, and Dr. Jones busts out with nary a scratch. Seems to us that the science in this movie is about as baked as Indy's body would be.
Now, John, upon watching the movie, what's your first impression? Can Indy make it?
It's not so much a question of whether Indy dies, but more like how many times he dies.
Uh-oh. When a nuclear physicist starts keeping a death count, you know things don't look good for Indy.
Let me break it down for you. This looks about like where Ground Zero was in the movie.
Okay, so like this bridge will be Ground Zero.
A bit higher up, but yeah, pretty much.
In the name of scientific accuracy, it's time to move our refrigerator downstream.
I think I might need a little help with this. No more.
Who knew science could be so sweaty?
Okay, so that bridge down there is where the bomb went off, okay?
The fridge appears to fly out of the blast zone. Did Indy just buy himself a lifeline?
Eventually, it has to land. To see if he's gonna survive that, we're gonna need some math.
I think I know somebody who can handle that.
To calculate the impulse force acting on the fridge as it flies through the air, bounces around, and lands, we'll need to look at mass, velocity, and time. We guesstimate the mass of the lead-lined fridge at 350 pounds, and add actor Harrison Ford's weight, 218 pounds, for a total mass of 568 pounds. The fridge, carried by high winds, flies past a racing Jeep. So let's give its velocity a nice round estimate of, say, 100 miles per hour. Altogether, the sheer bouncing around would create a force of 260,000 pounds. Applied to a 568-pound fridge, that's a force equivalent to 458 Gs. In other words, the fridge, and Indy inside of it, would be totally crushed.
Frankly, it'd be better for him if he'd been crushed by the blast, because what's coming next is nuclear radiation.
The nuclear fission process involves a uranium-235 nucleus absorbing a neutron and then breaking into two smaller nuclei and some extra neutrons. These extra neutrons cause even further nuclear fission and a whole lot of neutron radiation.
Okay, so Indy stumbles out of the fridge, but we see him scrubbing down later in the movie. Wouldn't that get rid of all the radiation that he was exposed to?
That'll get rid of the radioactive fallout that's fallen on him after the explosion. He still has all the neutron radiation he got during the explosion. At about 100 rems, you get all sorts of bone marrow problems, okay? You're more susceptible to infections, you have anemia, fatigue. Once you get to about 300 rems, you start getting reddening of the skin like a sunburn, and your hair starts to fall out.
500 rems is enough to kill most people. In fact, according to our experts, Indy has died three times over.
Okay, John, so what you're telling me is that Indy's feverish, he's red, he's balding, he's vomiting, he's sterile, and he has less than 50% chance of making it.
Is there any hope for Indy? What about that frigid air he was hiding in? The shot from the movie reveals it was lead-lined.
No such thing. You don't have lead-lined household refrigerators, which is what this is supposed to be. Lead is a metal. Metal conducts heat. You don't want it in the lining of your refrigerator, which is supposed to keep things cold. The only reason you would have a lead-lined refrigerator is if you want to put something radioactive inside and keep it cold and have it not leak radiation outside the fridge.
But what if there was?
Even if the government had custom-made a lead-lined fridge, Indy still got a couple of problems. Assuming the lead to be 1 millimeter thick, the typical thickness of the outer layer of a refrigerator, that much lead would only shield Indy from about 10% of the radiation. So Indy still gets exposed to 549 rems, and there's a 75% chance he's gonna be dead within 12 weeks.
Okay, there's still one shred of hope. What if Indy waited out the fallout inside the fridge?
It would take him about an hour to consume all the oxygen in the fridge, and he'd suffocate.
Once again, Advantage Mushroom Cloud.
I'm sorry, Indy. I tried. But that lead-lined refrigerator is your coffin.